For this lesson, you need to open the sample file, The World's Fastest Cars, from your Sample Files folder. This worksheet shows details of some of the fastest cars in the world. Until September 2007, the Bugatti Veyron was the fastest car in the world. Shelby has now stolen the crown with their SSC Ultimate Aero. There'll be an even faster car by the time you watch this video. We need to insert a row above row 4 in order to add the new car to the list. To insert a blank row above row 4, you need to first select row 4. You can use the skills that you learned in lesson 2.6. That is to hover the mouse cursor over the row 4 column header and then click with the mouse. Now that I've selected row 4, I can right-click anywhere in the selected range and select Insert from the shortcut menu, and the new rows added. Let's now add the details for the Shelby. The make is Shelby. The model is the SSC Ultimate Aero. The top speed is 257 miles an hour. The 0 to 60 time is 2.7 seconds. The brake horsepower is 1183. The price, $654,400. And the country it's made in is, of course, the USA. Now notice that Excel has helpfully bold-faced row 4 for me. Excel figured out that because row 3 was bold-faced, perhaps I wanted row 4 to be bold-faced as well. But of course, Excel's got it wrong. So let's remove the bold-faced attribute from row 4. To do that, I first select the row by clicking on the Row Header button. Then, on the Home tab on the ribbon, in the Font group, I can click the Bold button to remove the bold attribute from row 4. Inserting a column is very similar to inserting a row. Imagine that I want to insert a column to the left of column A. I would do that by clicking on the Column A column header, then right-click in any of the selected cells and select Insert from the shortcut menu. Deleting a row or column is very similar to inserting a row or column. Simply select the row or column, right-click in any of the selected cells, and this time select Delete from the shortcut menu. Quite often you'll want to insert more than one row, and beginners do this by inserting the rows one at a time. For example, imagine you wanted to insert 4 rows above row 4. You'll see untrained Excel users selecting row 4 and insert, and insert, and insert, and insert. But of course, there's a better way of doing it than that. Let's delete those rows that we've just inserted. And imagine I want to insert 6 rows above row 7. I'd begin at row 7 and select rows 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. That's 6 rows. And then right-click anywhere in the selected cells and insert. And you can see that I've inserted 6 rows in one operation. I'll now right-click inside those selected rows and select Delete from the shortcut menu. Inserting multiple columns is just the same as inserting multiple rows. If I wanted 3 columns to the left of column C, I'd select columns C, D and E, right-click and Insert. And to delete them, once again I'd select the 3 columns and right-click and Delete. As well as inserting and deleting rows and columns using the mouse, and I must say that the mouse is my favourite way of doing this operation, you can also use the ribbon. Let's insert a row to the left of column D. To do this, I click anywhere in column D, and then Home tab on the ribbon, Cells, Insert, and Insert Sheet Columns. And I've now inserted a new column. To insert a new row, similarly, I click anywhere in the row, and then Home on the ribbon, Cells Group, Insert, and Insert Sheet Rows. To delete a column, I'd first select the column, and then Home on the ribbon, Cells Group, Delete, and Delete Sheet Columns. And the same for the row. Select the row, Home on the ribbon, Cells, Delete, and Delete Sheet Rows. A really fast way of inserting rows and columns is to use a shortcut key combination. It's quite a difficult one to remember, though. It's Ctrl-Shift-Plus to insert rows or columns. Let's see that in action. I'll select row 5, and then Ctrl-Shift-Plus inserts a row. And you can see how quickly I can insert rows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I've inserted 5 rows. Columns, same thing. Select the column, Ctrl-Shift-++, and I've inserted 3 columns. There's also a shortcut key for deleting rows and columns. It's not Ctrl-Shift-Minus as you'd expect, but simply Ctrl-Minus. I'll press Ctrl-Minus-Minus-Minus to lose those 3 new columns. Then I'll select row 5, and once again, Ctrl-Minus-Minus-Minus, and as I press the minus key, I delete a row every time. You've now completed Lesson 3.1. Insert and delete rows and columns.